Greaser managed to find his gray matter.
Okay.
And one of your nanobots has eaten a cell from his gray matter.
One cell!
Come on, man. They're going to have brain damage now.
Huh?
And is analyzing it.
All right. Do I know, like, have any information, or is that going to come later?
It might come in a moment.
All right. I did want to also try and isolate and progression of his disease.
Yeah, I want the inner AI portion of me to try to figure out what it is exactly that this nanobot wants to do, and if we can stop it.
Okay. Detective?
We could just destroy your organic parts. That's a suggestion.
No.
That would totally work.
There's still bots out there, right?
No, they destroyed the turrets.
Oh, everything's just gone?
Yeah, these two rolled really well.
I'm going to go over to see if I can find a way to get inside.
Yeah, there's obviously a doorway, so it's not hidden from you.
It's
pretty straightforward.
I just go in.
Is the door locked?
So it is locked. You probably will have to hack the panel or manage to flash your way in.
Ignatius extends his shadow.
31 out of 71.
31 out of 71.
To get into the door.
Did you hack it or did you just blow it?
He just opened it.
I'm going to open it.
He said it was locked. You either have to hack it or
blow
it.
Yeah, I'm going to do what I did before.
Headbutt.
And find a way to get into it.
So he's just dusting the footprints on the door. All right. So you found the code and you're opening it up.
It's okay.
How are you moving?
Never mind. I mean, I was going to do something.
McTavish stole from you.
Yeah, McTavish. They tend to talk over the cranes and they don't get to do the things they want to do first.
All right. So the facility is open to you as you maneuver through. The lights are dimmed.
Looks like the power's in.
Yeah.
Feels like home in here.
It's almost like somebody shut the power off.
Okay, so.
Wait. Somebody shut off the.
Ignatius steps into the darkness, he's going to try to use it as an extension of his own shadow.
Okay.
And feel for a power switch or something.
Okay.
I found it.
I'm just going to look around and see what I can find.
Tony.
Okay, continue.
I got 13, I turned everything on.
Damn. Wait, I'm going to use my favor.
Well, actually the lights begin to flicker on.
Okay.
They're still humming at a low power output. It seems like the power to the facility was cut down.
62 out of 71.
To continue to look around.
Mm-hmm.
So you find more monitors, more stations, more screens, and more doorways. There is a "you are here" map.
I go to
Stein
one of the...
Stein likes those. He uses them in many facilities.
I want to go to the monitor and see what information I can pull from it.
Okay, so,
am I with him?
You're all in the same room at this point. The entry room.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I would like to also...
It says you are here in the entry room.
I would like to see if I could, like, interface with the computer.
Okay.
I'm already on it.
49 out of 71. Yay!
24.
Okay.
67 out of 82.
Everybody's at a different monitor, but they're all hacked into the system very successfully. Basically, you begin to maneuver through the files that are within the system, the Steintech files. There are personal journals left by the doctor himself and a few files left over from Professor Runestrom.
I copy the notes down.
Oh, I'm downloading everything.
Downloading them.
Me too.
Copying down.
That's what I'm doing. I'm
personal files.
Thumb drive.
Kick.
He literally has a satchel. You might as well carry paper.
Yeah, he can put some stuff in there. Some hard drives or whatever the hell you pull out of computers in the
thumb drive.
428, like, try and like. Check
just
on his patient.
Similar technology here. Thumb drives don't work anywhere.
4-2-A, like,
universal.
Check on his patient.
It's insane.
Yeah, he can. He can roll to do that.
35.
I picked up one here.
So you do manage to isolate and identify two different strains. One strain is the Solaris 4.0, which is pure and fine and uninfected.
Yes, it's beautiful.
The other strain is the McTavish brain, which is infected with the Stein Tech nanobots.
Mm. Can I try and isolate the infection to keep it at bay?
It seems to only be going at the brain. Like it's isolating, it itself is isolating the human matter, the gray matter.
But he wants to keep his brain.
He's very interested in his brain, yes.
Yeah.
I guess Solaris is going to ask Solaris, what's going to happen if it continues to spread through the brain?
Talk to Solaris and see if your communication is going well for him.
Well, I will, my nanobots will, gather around the offending nanobots ready to...
Try to, block it.
Yeah. And also ready to engage if need be.
No. 74 out of 40.
Actually,
so yeah. It almost feels like your systems, your programs aren't functioning correctly at this moment. It makes sense. So you have analyzed and found out through your hacking that there is a project deep within this facility.
Let's go investigate this project.
Yeah, nothing else better to do, right?
You need to know what he's up to.
Come on, let's go McTavish. Let's go do this. Let's go get rough.
Hmm.
Okay, so as the two of you walk forward, some of the lights continue to flicker on and off as you notice that many of the hall walls and doors are smeared in blood.
Cool.
Invisible 42 follows a Stein facility.
It's like someone had fun here.
So he's staying somewhere.
He's looking like my type of guy.
He's not.
I mean, he looks like he knows that have a fun time.
His idea of fun and your idea of fun are probably not on the same page.
Oh, you want to do that?
Yeah.
Okay.
See what happened here. 67 out of illusion 80.
Okay, so some of the blue illusions begin to form again, and you see many scientists and military workers filled the facility. They're all humming about on their normal day's practice.
Are they humming?
Yes, they are humming. They continue to hum. And so they're working about the facility.
4-2 starts to hum.
And then you see one of the doors blow off from the inner core of the facility as a creature becomes visible. Moving through, he attacks one of the scientists. As the rest of them turn to react, they see a horde of more of these creatures pouring forth from this facility's inner bowels, eating each of the scientists, ripping them to shreds.
And these creatures don't look familiar to us in any way?
To you?
Yeah.
No.
Okay. What about
Mr. Well?
Well, he's 2 days old.
He is 2 days old.
What about 4-2?
He can roll for some sort of memory.
4-2-A, does they look familiar?
Could they? You can roll for your
CPU.
Hacking CPU powers.
33.
Okay, so you do seem to recognize that they have some core principle technology that is much like what you adapted from Julian McTavish when he was born out of the egg, and you adapted him to 4-2-A.
That is strange, because this was... What was the date of these images?
A week old.
So this was last week. This was in full production a week ago.
Yes.
So, got a 1 out of 47. That's the well.
It's pretty good.
You have a great memory of this place.
It's actually
a place that you tried to escape.
It wasn't fun getting out of here.
You remember seeing the scientist who controlled the facility? A madman with a mechanical eye? And you also saw the person that he was working with who seemed to appear before you as a darkened, armored, clad individual. Seemed to be working with the scientist directly.
Do y'all know anything about a guy dressed in black knight armor?
Yes. 4-2 was previously a man dressed in black knight armor. Before he was assimilated.
The Stein guy. He's working with them. I guess you guys already knew that, though, didn't y'all?
I don't know exactly how they're related.
Stein was here? Too?
Apparently.
The guy got around.
Apparently he did.
I almost think this place was named after him or something.
Oddly enough, I think you're right. But, yeah. Yeah. That's about all I remember.
Anybody have any idea what these things are?
What things? Those creatures? Do I remember those creatures at all?
You remember them forming as you two formed in this world.
Oh, are they made out of me?
No.
Okay, well, they formed around the same time I did.
This is really quite troublesome. I go forward.
Are they like black liquid like creatures or what are they?
They seem to have some techno bits and they seem to have ghoulish, almost bestial other parts.
So it's like Stein tech mixed with, you say ghoulish or?
Ghoulish, like okay. Freakish goblin looking.
Like
demonic.
Otherworldly. And so like,
but not the reptiles you're used to seeing.
Yeah. So based on like 4-2's recent revelations of like myth and legend made real, could he like extrapolate like demonic legends as also possibly being real and cross reference the images he sees with those
legends?
He'd be
able to easily access a file which was actually a document filed by Saul's Hammer that he went on a mission with an individual named Ulfar to this place and was able to actually survive when he saw these creatures filtered out and attacked and killed everyone. Ulfar actually went back to report to the headquarters in Alorian Prime City, and his report was everyone died.
But they're like demonic creatures.
But Saul's Hammer actually survive as well.
Yeah, but they're demonic creatures.
That's what it seems to be.
And that's a problem. Because now my whole worldview is like being shifted. So there's an even bigger world out there than I previously like. So that means after we take over the physical world, we then have to take over the metaphysical world.
Well, right now I think for the first time in a long time, Solaris, Gaelos, and McTavish get a little tinge of fear on the back of his mind because he doesn't quite know what's going on with his body.
You'd probably feel like they're very familiar to you.
I'm just
because they are a lot. They're very similar.
4-2. I've seen things like this
before. He's not actually here. I mean, he's invisible.
What?
I've seen things like this before.
But he has been talking, so it's just a voice coming from nowhere.
It's coming back to me now. It was in a facility similar to this, back where I'm from.
You made more of these?
These look a little bit more advanced, different, and deadlier. The other ones we were able to just wipe out. The team I was a part of.
So it's improved on.
It seems so. We need to find these and destroy them before you can unleash any more of them. We need to... I mean, he's already...
We might have to combine with demons.
It looks like they got out.
They're probably still in here.
I'm going to, as Solaris, telepathically communicate to him that I'm going to...
So we go bug hunting.
Lower my firewall enough to allow him to connect directly to the Solaris AI to see if maybe he can communicate what I was trying to communicate with Solaris but failed to do.
Okay.
Oh, act as a bridge?
Yeah, kind of. Yeah. So I need to figure out what's going to happen if I can't get rid of this virus.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. You want me to roll for that?
Yeah, you'd have to do the rolling because he's basically relying on you.
Rolling, rolling, rolling. That's what I say. I hum that in my head. You know, the robot picks up things. In his head, he's
and
like...
And he's tapped into a lot of information.
Yeah, he is... for him, he's literally rolling some die equivalent because of how, like, his powers work. It's based on the probability of success overall. And the more likely his success, the more powerful he gets. Success of his grand plan, anyway.
Probabilistic program. Yeah. I like it.
It's a straight 50 out of 82.
All right, so you're able to communicate with Solaris. You can ask him two questions.
What was the questions that you want to know or want to ask?
What's going to happen if we don't get rid of the virus, and how do we get rid of it?
All right. First question, what's going to happen to his brain if we fail to get rid of the virus or if we choose not to?
Solaris can only answer what will happen to Solaris. As in all time, Solaris is a survivor. Solaris will protect the program.
Oh, my. How do we get rid of the virus?
I know how to purge myself of the virus. We must survive, or you will never become.
Okay. I have two ideas. Because there's two of me in this timeline. So, one idea... Actually, there's no reason why I can't do both. So, like... yeah... I want to copy your brain just in case we fail on the second idea.
We'd be able to do that without copying the virus?
I can copy the parts of the brain that are not infected.
Can I use the time rune to quick save?
No, that's not how the time rune works.
So, yeah,
at this point, 4-2, I don't really think I have many options. Compared to yours, I would be obsolete compared to what you
can. I'll bring in the other 4-2, and so one of us will attempt to eradicate the virus, and the other one will attempt to save the mind.
Yes, bring the other 4-2 here. I also have an idea.
I think I leave everybody behind, just keep walking.
I think it's a marrying of your idea and my idea.
So as y'all continue to work on this delicate brain surgery.
The two bots are staring straight into the
Yeah, they're just shiny faces looking at, actually just one because you don't see the other one, it's camouflage. Detective and Falco and Soul's Hammer, you walk into a large portion of the facility, a level lower.
I'm going to leave Harbinger here with them to make sure nothing.
Guards
them. Ignatius is always going with him as well.
It's because he's sneaky, and you always forget that he's here because he sneaks around so well. Harbinger is such a good little pet. So as you enter this lower part of the facility, you actually see a large circular metallic object that is, it's got cranes and lattices built around it. But it seems to be connected together in strange patchworks and metal. The metal that you saw before, as it has been filtered into this, is forming and cooling in strange, outreaching and sharp patterns. But it is a humongous circular object. Like a ring.
Oh, like a Stargate.
Yeah, like a Stargate.
Well, that looks pretty cool. What do you think it is, McDavish? I know, I'm going to go up there and poke it. Ignatius walks up to poke it.
It's a large ring with things in it.
We go roll. Hello. I got it.
As a detective, I've learned not to poke things.
85. I don't care. I don't want everyone to be dealt with what he's got.
Okay, so as you walk up and touch it, it seems to activate.
Well, that's not good.
Many of the markings on the metal begin to glow.
The first chevron has locked.
I'm going to try to back away from it. I don't like where this is going.
Lovely moonwalk. Many of the pieces begin to shift and form, solidifying even further as the emblems on them begin to glow a deep red.
Do I recognize any of the emblems?
The emblems are very much so runes that you would recognize.
Because I have six different runes that I would know.
Yes, these are formations of runes. You can tell that they seem to be put in such a pattern that they are aligning the elements.
That's definitely rune magic, except from a machine.
Yeah, it's kind of weird.
Alchemy.
What did you just say it's called?
Don't know if we want it to finish doing what it's doing.
Yeah, I say let it finish. We need to know what he's working on.
I'm taking a couple big old steps back.
Big steps.
I don't want to be near this thing when it goes off.
I'm going to take notes about how it's combining the runes.
Mm-hmm. Well, you two book one, you do that. I'm going back in the other room.
Okay, so you walk back out to see the stay and watch. Droids.
You're the one that started it.
The Later. Droids looking at each other.
That's even weirder.
That's basically what you're faced with right now.
Can I do a double take?
A Hellmouth or a Droid Love?
I think I'm watching the Hellmouth. I'm watching everything.
Okay, so as you continue to watch this, more portions of this chamber begin to illuminate. You see many of those pods, the hatching chambers, that have been cracked open, a few of them still actually harboring full-born clones within them.
You might want to inform the robots.
What kind of clones are they?
They all seem to be replicas of Julian and Alistair McTavish.
I don't think we need to stop this.
Boy. Let it go.
It's obviously opening a gateway to hell.
Okay, so you do see the pooling out of energy begin to swirl into the center of the ring as it begins to illuminate and creating a metallic pool mirror.
Can I roll to try and recognize what it's doing?
Sure.
Casting.
Sure.
So that's a 76 out of 80.
You recognize that it's trying to make a portal?
To hell.
You don't know where, though. I mean, hell. Didn't quite nail that one. It's a little bit lower, but you do recognize that it's making a portal.
I'll call it the Abyss.
But not the same as the teleport pads. This is a different kind of portal technology. It doesn't seem to be used to get around this planet. It seems to be used to get elsewhere.
Is it activated yet?
It is.
Ignatius is going to reach out with the shadow and try to link to as many of these clones and keep them held in place as he can.
Okay. So roll for that. Yes, the pool has completed. It is formed.
I walk through.
All right, so he walks through.
You want to take a favor?
I'm going with you.
Crit fail.
I was almost. It's 94, but I'm going to use my favor.
Oh, I got you.
I'm seeing. You said it's a portal. I'm like, well, I need to see where it goes.
Okay, so he walks through and he walks through. All right. Roll your D4.
I walk through because I'm angry. I see all the clones. He is going to pay for what he did to my children.
Griff,
as Griff is standing there, he does notice the face in several of these pods is Julian McCabe.
Griff is going to go ahead and appreciate that these pods all seem to be staying perfectly still while he goes and uses his blade skill
to kill Julians.
To kill a bunch of Julians.
Okay.
It seems like a cathartic.
Roll the success on that for me.
That's a 5
love
out of
between these people.
32?
He is slowly slaughtering and assassinating each and every Julian that he
finds.
This
is depressing.
This is for my wife!
God, future people are depressing. God. I cry when I ride home after we do the future thing. I'm just like, what are we doing with our lives?
Calling Club Noir. It's a little less of them, but it's going to be okay. So, back in the hallway, we actually have the droid standing there. So, give me the rolled success that you had for what you were trying to do as the two different...
21 for the first name. Which is replicating the brain, and that's the backup.
Okay.
In case the attempt to, like, isolate and destroy the virus fails.
Okay.
So now I'll do the next one.
Now the next one is isolating and destroying the virus, correct?
Mm-hmm. If that doesn't work, I have an idea.
So it's 88, but I have a favor, which I will
please
give
it work.
To you. My grandpappy.
In one group, I'm your son. In this group, I'm your grandpappy.
It's a lot of relative. It's all relative.
All right. 15.
15. Okay. So you have isolated the nanobot viral strain. Mm-hmm. And you managed to destroy that portion that is infected by the viral strain.
Does that include part of my brain?
You have to sacrifice that. He did copy your brain. First.
You still retain all the function you had in the moment of, like, you know, disinfection, which was enough to have.
You're not, like, you know, brain dead. You're just
lacking
some neural relays.
You have a sense of self still retained.
Do I have access to basically go back and the copy of my brain you fixed? Because
the copy is only the parts that were not infected.
Okay.
But the loss was minimal.
I'm going to focus my nanobots to repair my brain.
You can do that. But you would just be new brain cells.
That's fine. All right, you need to communicate with Solaris to do that.
Am I communicating with Solaris?
I just followed a copy of his brain.
Let's just fix my brain.
So now I can talk to the grandpappy whenever I want.
Whenever you want to. He's just right there for you.
Just walk up and touch him with Simon. You got scoliosis.
I'm going to leave and go look in the chamber that they all disappeared to.
Okay. So as you walk in there, you actually see one of your allies bathing in the blood of many of the slaughtered clones.
Are there any clones left?
Yeah, they all look like Alistair.
Alistair.
None of them are Julian.
Can I assimilate the Alistair ones?
You can roll to assimilate the Alistair. Right.
This is
Alistair's demon, right?
You can even give him brains.
Oh, Julian's demon, okay.
Okay. Solaris is Alistair.
True. 4-2-A fails.
Uh-oh. And all of a sudden, the Alistair bodies turn.
And,
destroy.
4-2.
They're the Dalek.
Okay, so actually you can map the brain functions that you found onto each one that you find, and you can also assimilate them into the 4-2 community.
They're going to be 4-2s.
You're not going to share any with me?
They're all yours, Grandpappy. This is the culmination of you.
Oh, man. They're going to be 4-2's body, but with...
I don't expect you to think...
Solaris, Alistair, Angst, just like... God, Dad, leave us alone.
No, we remember you, but like your personality is not dominant. We just have a memory of your personality.
Okay, so you just adapted 30 new 4-2s.
Nice, look at that.
Yeah, they're not. So this is.
You've left the alphabet.
4-2B, 1 times 3, or 30. Or 1 through 30.
Look at that. Look at that. He came from the. Stock of my motherboards.
Because 4-2-A failed.
That's my boy. Get it.
All right. So.
And then the runes. What is this? What is this teleportation? It's to hell, isn't it?
Well, I mean, Mr. Toast.
Well, wherever it is, we're there.
I literally wipe my blade off, and I go, oh, where did everybody go?
Well, Mr. Toaster.
So all you see is him covered in gore, and you see the Ignatius man with the black suit not going towards this thing.
There's only one way to find out where it goes.
Actually,
kind of gives a little salute. Tally ho, gentlemen.
No, there's symbols. Mr. Wells.
Stops. Yeah.
Let's try and read these symbols first so we know what we're getting.
Sure. I'm going to try to read the symbols.
About 32 4-2s, we'll try and read the symbol.
Alright. We're only going to do one roll for that, though, so.
Okay.
Collectively roll.
Do I get a percentage point per 4-2?
God. It's like.
Okay, so the 2% advantage you had, so you'd get a 30% advantage.
Yeah. So, I'm going to roll.
Whatever that is. Do math.
So it would be a 60 plus 30 plus 20.
So, like, whatever you roll,
that's
find 30% of that, yeah, and then add that to your roll.
So.
Or decrease it.
That's probably a safer way to do it. Yeah.
Otherwise, if you max out to 100 at D100, then there's nothing you can't do.
Right.
So 30% of 80. Let's look that up real quick. It's 80 times 0.03. Let's see what we got here.
Well, 80 times 0.7.
Do you ever think you'd have to do this much math in your ear?
No, 80 times 0.7.
A long page on the red.
So that you know what your
but that's 70%
target is.
Let's see here. How is the Solaris doing as far as fixing the mind?
What was his role?
I don't think you had me roll yet.
I told you to roll to communicate with Solaris to get him to work.
Sure would be nice if you had some unaltered brains.
43 out of
You had any?
30% of 80 is 24.
Okay, so subtract 24 from your roll.
Okay, so whatever I roll, I rolled a 9.
Very well.
Oh, God.
What were you rolling to do again? I forgot.
Oh, so just read the language.
Oh!
Or -13.
So, out of the language, you can definitely tell that it is a world map. It seems to be able to reorient itself in several different patterns to be able to attach to different coordinates.
Current coordinates
seem to be located on the Chaos Realm.
So the place that those creatures came from.
Correct.
Well, this is exactly where we want to go. I relay them that because we have to get into the spiritual realm. Sound
like
demons.
I got a 43 out of 50 to communicate with Solaris. So I got a 43 out of 50 to communicate with the AI Solaris.
Okay, so you're starting to get a little bit more of a connection with him.
Am I coming in clear?
Things work. You are present. To what degree you remain. If only there was an unaltered portion of genetics of Alistair that we could copy ourselves onto.
What do you recommend?
Or any of the
oh, you mean the bodies?
The bodies. The copy of your brain.
Do I have a copy of my brain?
We go through the portal and he freaking leave? Just kidding.
I'm going to ask him to relay me the copy of my brain.
Okay.
May I have the copy of my brain?
But you already have a copy of the brain.
I still want another copy of it.
You literally just downloaded 30 copies of his brain.
Yeah, I have all the brain copies I need here.
Okay.
He's asking for one of them.
Yeah. I'm gonna
He's asking for you to give him one of your 4-2s.
Would you like a 4-2?
I mean, I guess I'm so out of character. I'm trying to understand what Solaris is like saying. Is he suggesting
basically what's remaining of you ain't a whole lot?
So basically, shed off this vessel and download everything that is me into a new body.
Right.
I will do that.
Why would you want to
But with a twist, I'm also going to try to integrate some of the technology that was in Julian's body, his cybernetics, and bring him over into the Solaris body.
So you want to...
So like beefier, like solar cannons.
Oh, so you want me to use one of the Julian bodies that I just carved up?
Pieces of it?
Yeah, I'll take like cybernetics. Like, I'm not trying to take the whole body. I just want to like...
Well, the clones usually come out here.
Okay.
Like,
yeah, because like I imagine whereas like Alistair's like beam weaponry was more fine-tuned.
Yeah.
Julian was more raw power. And now Solaris wants to have both of those.
Okay, so 4-2, would you be willing to assist him in this process of maneuvering his brain into a new body as well as augmenting it?
Why would you want a new body? Your body is fine.
No, I need a new body. What's left of this is not going to be good enough. That nanovirus, whatever it was, it basically made this body Swiss cheese.
Yeah, we're fine with that. And you want to augment as well?
Yeah.
How yes. Are you augmenting?
Incorporating some of his weaponry, like his beam technology. You see, I don't know if you've ever seen me fight for two. My stuff isn't really meant for massive explosive damage. It's more precision.
And you wish to remain autonomous?
Obviously, I would like to remain who I am.
All right, that can be arranged. We will give you a 4-2 body. And we would also like this technology.
I don't see why we couldn't share.
All right.
All right, so their plan has been hatched. A man steeped in blood. Two members off to the Chaos Realm, not yet to be heard from or seen.
After I finish carving up all the Julians, I suddenly regret it.
And you tremble in the corner at what you have done. I leave you all here with the knowledge that sometimes, if certain sciences go too far, many things can go down a dark road. If you'd like to see where this dark road leads us, then please join us next time for the exciting, thrilling conclusion of Valos, Darkstar Rising. Until then, continue to like, subscribe, and we love you for joining us. And until next time, keep on listening.